So here is a comparison of major and minor groove. Most sequence specific DNA binding proteins or the regulatory proteins bind with this bind in major groove rather than minor groove. The groove binding drugs are some of the drugs can be present can be found there. The groove binding drugs, which are the intercalators, can be found to be bound with the minor groove region. Okay, the minor groove region. Some of the drugs can also only bind with this minor groove region, because in those diseases, the main goal of us to block the DNA from multiplying. So we need to add a drugs that can be adhered to any site. So irrespective of sequence regulation or sequence specificity, we design drug. Because if we regulate, if we make a drug that will bind with a particular sequence, it need to find that sequence. It will take some time. And it will not may it may not find that sequence very randomly. That's why you need to design a drug which can attack with any part of the DNA. That's why you design some drug which will eventually gonna bind the minor groove rather than the major groove. Okay. And many non-sequence specific proteins are there, like histones, that will, can bind with the minor groove. Okay. Now let's talk about the energies involved in the grooves. The energies that can be found in the grooves are the stacking interactions. What is the stacking interaction is made up with? It is made up with actually the hydrophobic forces as well as the van der Waals interaction, which is a dipole-dipole interaction. So this kind of interaction can lead to the formation of the highly energetic molecule, which is DNA. Highly energetically stable molecule, which is DNA. The additional stabilization can be done with an attack of hydrogen bonds. But remember one thing. The most of us think about the hydrogen bonds to hold the structure of DNA, but the actual thing is that the base stacking interaction can be placed in the highest place, because the base stacking interaction plays the key role in attaching or involving the structure of DNA, in maintaining the structure of the DNA. Okay, then the hydrogen bonding, then the electrostatic forces.